Grace and peace. Welcome to Sabbath School Study Group. My name is Chris Bailey, and we are in part four of this five-part series. Today, we want to talk about provoking one another to good works. And as a community of servants, the power that we have to do this by the Spirit of Jesus Christ. So let's pray that, Father, in your name, that you would help us to see the gift that we have as brothers and sisters to push in Jesus' name. Amen. The Bible uses this idea of provoking one another to good works. Another verse, probably the more popular verse where they use that word provoke or provocation, where it says, fathers, provoke not your children to wrath. And that's real, and that's true, and that's powerful. But I love this one maybe even more because this has a positive connotation, but the other one's a little bit negative, where the whole idea of provoking one another to good works. What does that mean? Well, as a community of believers, we have the right and we have the opportunity to push one another. But if we push upward, push onward, push forward. See, naturally, when we're crammed into this arc of grace, it's easy to bump arms, flying on the plane, coming out here to California, sitting next to a gentleman, and I accidentally bumped his arm. I was trying to read a book, and I remember I was down and I moved my foot and I bumped his leg, because in tight quarters, that's going to happen. So in the tight quarters of the house of God, and especially when things get intense or thick, when wills contradict or when situations arise among sinners who've been saved by grace, the desire to push is going to be there. But what I want to encourage us is, if you're going to push, push up, push onward, push forward. Don't push away, don't push down, and don't push back. Don't go back. If you're going to push, this is God's will for his children. Look at what he says here in Hebrews 10:24. Let's consider one another. Think about each other, but think about each other to provoke unto love and to good works. If we're going to push people, let's push them to do good things. Let's push each other to grow. This does not mean I push people to do what I want them to do. But I want to be in a position where you can use me as leverage to live. You can use me as a lesson to follow. You can use me as an example, even in my mistakes, of what not to do. So I'm actually pushing people forward, upward, onward. Hebrews 10:25 says, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together. Let's keep coming together, as the manner of some is, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. Exhorting, encouraging, not ignoring. I said ignoring, not ignoring, and not, what's a way of saying causing anxiety? Not stressing me, not getting on my nerves. We know how to do that as the people of God, because we're so tightly woven, and that thing can get so tight that it can start squeaking and start squealing a little bit and creaking. But man, if we're going to creak and if we're going to squeal and if we're going to, make the screeching sound, make a sound of hope, encourage people. Most people know the wrong that they're doing. They need to know how they can get it right. And the good news of the gospel is that we know not how, we know who can get it right. And through him, we know how. I didn't know how. I thought I knew how. I tried it for years trying to get it right on my own. But when I stopped focusing on knowing how and knowing who, that's when the game changed for me. That's when my life just became something that I don't even know how I'm here, but I know I'm here because of what Jesus has done in my heart and because of the change. And now I really want to focus, especially with my own family, on being an encourager for Christ. In fact, Galatians 6:10 says, as we have therefore opportunity, let's do good unto all men, especially unto them who are of the household of faith. The beautiful thing about church is that we've got a group of people. We've got a core group of humanity out of the billions that are on. This is my circle that I know I'm going to try and do good to this group. I'm going to make sure I make an effort to really bless this group. So if I cook, I want to make sure, okay, I'm going to try and cook a dish for this group on this potluck day or this dinner day, because those are my people. We believe the same thing, and we're headed into the same direction, the home, same destination, I pray. I want to make sure I make an effort to do good to them, not just to my clients. You know, some of you have businesses or you do things where you work for clients, and obviously everybody wants to win a contract or win business, and you'll go out of your way to impress them or to put on a good face. Let's do that for the house of faith, especially your own house. I'm talking about where you live, your own family, whether they live with you or whether all your children have grown and gone on. Be like that to them first. Not only, but first, and then treat your people in your church, and then treat the people outside of your church, just like you treat them. So eventually what starts to happen? I really don't have to keep inventory of how I treat people if I just treat everybody good. That's why he just said, do good to all men. Because then I don't have to cheat count. Well, she's in the church. Well, that's my cousin, or, well, that's my husband. I'm just going to love everybody, because that's what Jesus did. That's what fishermen do, right? When you throw out a net, you're not picking and choosing. I'm just throwing out a net to everybody. Everybody just get blessed. Because that's the net. That's the love that got me. Finally, Hebrews 13:16. But to do good and to communicate, forget not. For with such sacrifices, God is well pleased. Do good and to communicate, if you will, good. Don't forget it. I love this verse because it's real. We can forget to say good because there's so much bad and there's so much true bad. I mean, you can't overlook it, the obvious mess. But don't forget the good. Don't forget to say good. Don't forget to not just communicate it, but do good. Yeah, don't forget it. Do good. That's it. That's the end of this study. Do good. And don't forget to do it, especially to those who we claim to be our brothers and sisters, and even especially to those who are literally our brothers and our sister, our family.